Just like that. Just like that. If somebody's paying for something and I don't have cash on me, it's super easy to use.
And you may use payment apps like Venmo or PayPal or Cash App the exact same way. But a new rule could mean you owe more in taxes if you make more than $600 with business transactions on the app. Under the new law, you'd have to pay taxes on that money. Let's get you more. Armanda Lujewski gets us more on what counts and what doesn't. Amanda.
The IRS wants to know more about your finance app transactions. Some have nothing to worry about. Others do. We asked the experts to find out why it's happening.
Government loves taxes.
Victor Klar, an economist at FGCU, says the new rule is one more way for the government to track your spending.
It's not like the underground economy existed before Venmo. You can pay people in cash. People have done it for hundreds of years, if not longer.
The new rule targeting your online transactions goes into effect during the 2022 tax season.
Sometimes I do get like large transactions and I don't want to be taxed for that.
Maya Griffith is a sophomore at FGCU. She tells me her parents send her money through the app to help cover rent or a school bill.
That was just an easy way for them to send it to me and not have to deal with like going to the bank with a check and all that stuff.
Easy and convenient.
I usually just use it for like when I'm splitting the bill with my friends or like I bought them a meal so then they'll buy it for me next time kind of thing. But
and now that any income over $600 a year could be taxed.
So we've got with billions of transactions that would take place every day. How is the IRS going to keep track of all that?
Experts say the new rule could create problems, but also change habits.
Then it might actually nudge people to report less income.
They ask you, well, you had this amount come into your account of $1,200. That's income. You should have paid taxes on it. Well, no. That wasn't income. My mom gave me that so I could pay my rent this month. Prove it.
It could potentially revert people back to cash.
This is certainly an eye-opener. I think people are going to be a little more mindful of how they use it. If they keep trying to keep their hands in your pockets, maybe cash is the answer.
In Lee County, Amanda Lojeski, ABC 7.